Example number 5. Explain the following questions based on the size of atoms or ions and other properties. Now, first question is, arrange the following species in the increasing order of their atomic size. What I'll do is, I'll write the element first. Whenever they ask question related to atomic radius, write the number of protons. Cl minus, S2 minus, calcium 2 plus. Atomic number or the number of protons is equal to 18, 19, 17, 16, 20. If you count the number of electrons, it's 18, 18, 18, 18, 18. In all the cases, they are of 18 electron. Therefore, the deciding factor is the proton. When the number of protons are greater than electrons, the attraction is more. As a result, the size decreases. Correct? When the protons are more, the electrons are attracted towards the nucleus. As a result, the size of the atom decreases. Now, what they're saying? Decreasing order. Decreasing order means highest should come first. You tell me, in which case, the number of protons are less and the electrons are more, wherein you cannot have that attraction force more. It's in case of sulfur 2 minus. Why sulfur 2 minus? It has 2 negative charges and also it has 16 protons and 18 electrons. Number of protons are very less compared to electrons. As a result, the attractive force is less in this case. Therefore, it will have highest atomic radius. Then, after that, the same logic is applicable for Cl minus. In case of argon, the number of protons and electrons are proper. Therefore, the regular trend was observed. Now, how to choose between these two? More the number of proton, lesser the size. Therefore, calcium 2 plus has definitely lesser size compared to K plus. Therefore, K plus is greater than calcium 2 plus. The same logic is applicable for aluminium also, the second order. All of this has 10 electrons. But the deciding factor is what? Proton. I'll write it here. This is 13, 12, 11, 9, 7 and 8. All of this has 10 electrons. In which case the number of protons are very much less and the electrons are same? Very much less will be N3 minus. Therefore, N3 minus has highest. Then comes oxygen 2 minus. Then comes fluorine. How to choose between these three? Lesser the charge, more the radius. Therefore, then it will be Na plus. Then Mg2 plus. Least one is for aluminium 3 plus. This is the correct order. Then, if you consider the second part of the question, what are isoelectronic species? And name the species which are isoelectronic with the following atoms or ions. Isoelectronic species means atoms or ions having same number of electrons. Atoms or ions having same number of electrons. If you consider rubidium comes under the alkali metal. Its atomic number is 37. Rubidium atomic number is 37. Rb plus will be how many electrons? 36 electrons. 36 electrons. Which is the element having 36 electrons? It's krypton. If you consider F minus, choose the noble gas neon. Or it can be Na plus. Anything can be chosen. Similarly, Mg2+ has 10 electron. Therefore, it's again neon or any other element can be taken. Argon. Argon will be Cl minus, S2 minus, or it can be calcium 2+. Next, arrange the following species or atoms in the decreasing order of their reducing character. Reducing character increases down the group. If you know only this statement, it's more than enough. They've given sodium, magnesium, and aluminium. So this is the right answer itself, because sodium, magnesium, and aluminium. This is across the period. Across the period, reducing power decreases. Therefore, Na being highest, next Mg, then Al. This is proper. Then, magnesium, calcium, strontium. So, if you consider magnesium, calcium, and strontium, even if you consider this, there belongs to the same group actually. It's Mg, calcium, and strontium. I told you, down the group, reducing power increases. Therefore, strontium greater than, calcium greater than Mg. Next, sodium, potassium, and rubidium. They all belong to the same group. That's Na, potassium, and rubidium. So, sodium being least actually. So, highest to lowest you have to arrange. Rubidium is greater than potassium. Then comes sodium. What about F minus, Cl minus, Br minus, and I minus? F minus being most stable and electronegative, fluorine. So, that has less tendency. Reducing agent should undergo oxidation. F minus cannot be oxidized easily. Therefore, it should be in the reverse order. That is, I minus is greater than Br minus, Cl minus, and F minus. Next, the decreasing order of the reactivity of group 1 element is cesium greater than, rubidium greater than, potassium, sodium, lithium. Whereas for group 17, the reactivity order is chlorine greater than fluorine, then you have bromine and iodine. Why is it so? If you consider group 1 element, ionization energy decreases down the group. When the ionization energy is less, it can easily take part in the reaction. But for group 17 element, we are saying that chlorine is highest and iodine is least, because this has more electron affinity. More electron affinity, that's why it can undergo reaction easily. Next question is, predict the formula of the stable binary compound. Binary compound you have to find out. First is, between magnesium and nitrogen, magnesium valency is 2. Since it is a metal, I'll write it as 2+. Nitrogen valency is 3. Since it is a non-metal, I'm writing 3-. The formula will be Mg3N2, magnesium nitride. So it is Mg3N2. If you consider silicon and oxygen, silicon belongs to group 14, that's plus 4. Oxygen stable valency will be 2. Therefore, 2 ones are, 2 twos are. Therefore, you get SiO2. Element with Z is equal to 71. Z is equal to 71 is nothing but lutetium it is. For lutetium, the common oxidation number is always plus 3. Because it's a lanthanide. For all lanthanide, plus 3 is the common oxidation number. You have F minus. Therefore, you get LuF3. Phosphorus valency is 5. Plus 5. Fluorine is minus. Both of them are non-metal. But fluorine being highest, I am writing negative for that. So the formula should be PF5. Lithium and oxygen, Li is plus, oxygen is O2 minus. Therefore, the formula should have been NLi2O. Then, aluminium and iodine, aluminium valency is plus 3 and here it is minus. Therefore, you get AlI3. Aluminium iodide, triiodide, lutetium fluoride, trifluoride, silicon dioxide, phosphorus, pentafluoride, lithium oxide. Next, identify the element that would tend to gain 2 electron. 2 electron is gained by oxygen. Name the element, it should be oxygen. Identify the group having metal, non-metal, liquid as well as gas at room temperature. You should have metals, non-metals as well as gas at room temperature. It's nothing but group 17 in the periodic table. That is halogens. Because you have fluorine is a gas, chlorine gas, Br2 is a liquid, I2 is a solid, and At, astatine, is a solid, which is a metal. This is a metal, and these four are non-metals. And you have a gas as well as liquid at room temperature. Therefore, it is halogens. And group is group 17. Identify the element with 5 electrons in the outermost shell. Name the element with 5 electrons in the outermost shell. So, which is the element having 5 electrons in the outermost shell? It's any group 15 element. Any group 15 elements. Any group 15 element is nothing but nitrogen, phosphorus, or any other element can be taken. So here I'll take nitrogen. Identify the element that would tend to lose 2 electron. Alkali metals. Any alkali metal, it's Mg, I'll take it. Because it tend to lose 2 electron to become Mg2+.